let's count together from 0 to 19. So we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And now we go to the two-digit numbers. And then we go to 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. Now, why did I do this? Well, the whole point of this is to see a pattern here, especially in these two-digit numbers. What do we see is true about all of these numbers that are, you could think of them, they're being in their teens? Well, they all, you might see, have a 1 as their first digit. And that 1 is sitting in what we'll call the tens place. It literally says that each of these numbers, that 1 represents a 10. What do I mean by that? Well, if we go up to 10 over here, this is telling us that this 1 represents 10, and then this 0 represents 0 ones. So 10 is 10 plus 0. You say, oh, well, what's the big deal? We already knew that any number plus 0 is that number again. But I think you'll see the pattern as we go into these other numbers. So 11 is equal to, so this 1, the yellow 1 represents 10, and then this pink 1 represents 1. And then 12. 12, this yellow 1 represents 10. And then this pink 2 represents 2. Or you could think of it as this yellow 1 says this is 1 10. So we have a 10 right over there. And this is 2 ones. And you have 2 right over there. And we can keep going. I think you see the pattern. 13 is 10 plus 3. 13 is 10 plus 3. 14 is equal to 10 plus 4. Plus 4, 15, is equal to 10 plus 5. And I encourage you to pause the video now and try to finish the rest. Try to write 16, 17, 18, and 19 as 10 plus some other number. And really just make sure that you understand the pattern that's happening. So let's do that. So 16, so I can even write them all like this. They're all going to be 10, 10 plus something. So 16 is 10 plus 6. 17 is 10 plus 7, 18 is 10 plus 8, and 19 is 10 plus 9. And when you write it out like this, it becomes pretty clear that this 1 in each of these numbers represents 10, and then the digit on the right, that just represents that many ones.